Wait. Oh, please, you guys. This is hard.
We want to say to you, our viewer, we have loved it.
We want to thank you for letting us come into your homes and to your hearts and for treating us here in the studio and out in the community like friends and like family for all these years. And I want to get through this. I just want to say...
You're doing better than I did. Keep going.
I just want to say the best part of doing television for all these years for me has been working with this man. You see him out here as this funny and irreverent and very intelligent and insightful and, of course, boyish good looks person.
No hair.
He is all of that, but in fact, it takes a very strong personality behind the scenes to keep a show like this on the air. It was his creative force that put it together in the very beginning. It's been his will, his perseverance, and his belief in the show that's kept us on the air all these years. His insistence on excellence has kept good company, a quality show when all around us the competition was not taking the low road. It was it's been a wholesome show, it's been an uplifting show, and I have to say that for me to have the experience of learning from this man of television, because when I first started in 1975, I got to tell you, I was just, you know, a young woman with a little bit of talent, and this man taught me how to do television, and I think a lot of people who have come through this show, I'm going to talk through this show, through all the years, and we've had a lot of people on our staff have gone on to big shows, have gone on to stations around the country, and a lot of them, thankfully, have stayed with us through the years. And I think a lot of them would say that this is the best school of broadcasting in the country, and it's because Steve was such a great teacher. Mm. It's also a mission for... I'm going to talk. I know you're embarrassed, but I tell you, it's also a mission for this man to do this show. It was not like a job. It was like important to him to show the community in the best possible way, to give them a positive view of the Twin Cities. So it was a mission for him to do good work. And he taught me that it's a huge responsibility to be up here in front of 100,000 people every day, because you just got to do your very best all the time. Mm. And I appreciate that, but mostly I appreciate that you've been keeping me laughing for 18 years.
Oh. Well, that was beautiful, thank you. Sharon is a star.
Oh, you guys,
Sharon's an inspiration. Anyway, I recorded something because I knew I couldn't talk. Let's roll it.
Well, honey, I wanted to give you this message. I knew I wouldn't have the composure to do it when we do it on the last show, but I wanted it said. It has been an absolute, total joy to work with the one I love. It has been creative, spontaneous, wonderful, the best. In fact, it has been like a fairy tale. Now, I know because the show is going away, it is appropriate to get down to serious business and forget about fairy tales. And I have thought about that. But I've decided, forget it. The fairy tale is going to continue. We're just going to call it the fairy tale without TV. And now, another message.
And I'm looking forward for you to be a full-time mom for a while.
Right.
So our son gets a full-time mom for a while. She is the star that inspires me.
Oh.
And we want to thank you, our viewer, for supporting us the way you have. We love the Twin Cities, you love the Twin Cities, and you have given us the opportunity to do this. And it's been a wonderful, wonderful ride.
The best years of our lives. Thanks. And thanks to
thank
all the
you.
People who are here, who've been on the show through the years. Come on down, everybody.
Yeah, come on, guys.
We almost
made it.
Jeez. think that was hard.
Good job.
Sorry. Should we all look out there and say goodbye?
I say goodbye to what we had. The good time that made it last, I'll wait back. And I'll take with me the memory to be my sunshine after the rain. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Thank you.